what kind of experience you're producing for yourself. Once the very experience of your life is happening accidentally, once your very way of being is accidental, if you're existing here accidentally, then that's like being a potential calamity, you know. The beauty and the gracefulness of being human will be completely lost. A certain level of unawareness, a certain level of unconsciousness. You cannot fall back there, do what you want. It's never going to work. Essentially, you know the universe only from the context of your experience, every experience that you have is essentially conducted through your spine. Your spine is taken away, or what passes through the spine is in some way dislocated. There will be no experience, because you know the existence only by the context of your experience, and the basis of your experience is what is being conducted through your spine right now. Spine is seen as the axis of the universe. In yoga, they went to a different dimension and said, your spine is the axis of the universe. They're not saying this because they believe that you're in the center of the universe. Because you are capable of knowing the universe only from the context of your experience. And the basis of your experience is in your spine. If any individual has to truly determine the nature of his experience on this planet, 100%, then having a little bit of mastery over the spine becomes essential. Only that one who anyway determines the nature of his experience would dare to explore the full potential of his life, because he wouldn't hesitate to step into anything. If your experience is determined by anything other than yourself, naturally you'll try to avoid a few things and go after a few things. Whatever you consider as those which instigate or stimulate pleasant experiences, you go after that. Whatever you think will create unpleasant experiences, you'll go away from that. Once this division happens in your consciousness, that you divide the existence into two, knowing the ultimate unity becomes unnecessarily difficult. Why so much stress and joy, love, blissfulness is simply because of this. So that your experience is not determined by something else. Let's look at the possibilities. Unless you do not divide the world, it's very difficult to embrace the world, isn't it? In your consciousness, if you divide that this is mine, this is not mine, then trying to grab everything is very difficult. Either everything is mine or nothing is mine. This is okay. Nothing is mine. This is one way, it is okay. Or everything is mine. This is okay, it'll work. These are workable solutions. You are my enemy, but I love you. This is very, very difficult. It's a torture. Only if you are determining the nature of your experience, you can keep it pleasant within yourself no matter where you are. If people cause unpleasantness, they can do it only around you. never within you. Once this freedom is there, it's only then you can truly be inclusive. Otherwise, you get stuck. Every little sound that you hear, see if you can conduct it through your spine. Everything that you see, see if you can conduct it through your spine. Right now, I'm speaking. The sound itself is not flowing through this wire, but in the form of electrical impulse, it is going through this wire to the speakers and boom. If I get this, that's not going to work. This is not going to work. Spine is just like this. Spine itself doesn't know anything, but it is conducting everything. Only the one who understands that all this bunch of wires out there can manage this sound properly, how it should be. We've been having some trouble, you know.
Very few people realize the role of the spine in physical and mental health. Thousands of years ago, yogis gave a great importance to the development and protection of the spine. A healthy spine is the one which is erect and flexible, and so it is essential to maintain the erect posture when sitting, standing, walking, etc. Now, if you see your body, it has two halves split horizontally in the middle. The lower part weighs much more than the upper part. The large muscle and the biggest bone are in the lower body. This is because the spine is designed to support a certain amount of weight. Even a slight overload of the spine can create problems because it is the subtle thing made up of 33 pieces of bone. In terms of life, the spine is such an active place that you can easily rejuvenate and regenerate cells that have been lost there through simple practices. Now in yoga, the mind-body communication, which is done by nervous system and physical body, happens through nadis in the subtle body. You all might be knowing through various of Sadhguru's video that a nadi is nothing but a metaphysical concept that is the same as the nerve in the material world. Actually, you cannot see the nadi, but you can see the nerves in the material world. Nerves carry impulse or electric signals. Similarly, nadis carry prana or life energy or the vital energy. Of over 72,000 such nadis in the human body, 10 are considered very important, and out of these, 3 are relevant in meditation. And out of these 3, Sushumna nadi is one of the most important, which is exactly present where our spinal column does. That is, it is the passage of Kundalini energy to rise up from base of the spine to the top of the head. Additionally, yoga, in its simplest interpretation, is all about spine, and spinal strength comes from asana and pranayama. In an esoteric interpretation, yoga means union of left and right, Purusha and Prakriti, sun and moon in Hatha yoga, or union between Ida and Pingala nadis. So when we breathe in a still sitting posture or asana, we are beginning the journey of balancing both with our central nervous system. In an ancient metaphoric parlance, if the posture is bad, then our subtle bodies also fall out of alignment. If our physical body is not good by our subtle bodies, then we may find ourselves constantly disoriented mentally as well as physically. If our pranic body is out of alignment, then we will suffer from emotional disturbance. If our mental body is the culprit, then there is more serious repercussions, and so on. Not only this, human spine is a formidable structure that always rebelled against gravity and gave us the evolutionary breakthrough which no other creature of the planet has managed. Both spiritually and medically, the spine has been revered from Socrates to Hippocrates to modern science. Physically, on the top of the spine balances one of the heaviest head in proportion to the body on our cervical curve. Spiritually, the most powerful energy center is located in the brain. We even meditate by focusing on it, that we concentrate between the eyebrows, called the Asana Chakra. This is one of the most powerful chakra that, once opened, sets a chain reaction of physiological events down our spine, known as Kundalini awakening. While scientists still disagree that what exactly caused us to start walking on 2 feet, the fact remains that our spines are remarkable mechanical postures that defy gravity. It is that force that makes us a bit heavier around the middle, by the end of the day takes away height a bit, even 2 score years, makes our heart work harder and gives us lower back ache and swollen feet. Even babies are not spared and can often be seen sleeping bottoms up to counteract the effects of gravity and making their heart do less work to supply blood to more important parts of the body like the brain. So, to be efficient in our posture, we should be balancing this heavy ball that is our head on our curiously shaped spine exactly above our center of gravity. Our spine does that by its unique S shape and through the spinal disc that make it like a spring which can absorb shock and pressure too. Deviating our head even a little from this alignment would multiply the pressure felt by spine many folds. Yet this is what we all are doing all day round, that is completely captured by our mobile phones, thriving in our digital world. In my upcoming videos, I will be also talking about how by constantly looking upon your mobile phones, you are damaging your spine. So, at last, the spinal column is the basis of everything that you are experiencing right now. If you want to transcend the limitations of who you are right now, this is the most important part of our body. This is why it is also advisable in yoga to avoid any massage therapy, chiropractic procedure and similar things, not necessarily because they are something wrong, they are not at all wrong, they are absolutely right, but it is just that if you want to expand your perception grows from your spine. So when it comes to spinal procedures, it is best to avoid unless and until something very serious has happened in an accident or an injury that cannot be fixed without a surgery. If there is just a little bit of pain and trouble, do avoid these things. It takes work to build it, but we can build a spine. The spine regenerates very well compared to any other part of the body. Thousands of people who had worn out discs have completely recovered from it by simply doing certain practices. And one of the most efficient practices is doing Yoga Namaskar. I have talked about it in one of my videos. Do watch it after this video. So, when we put evolution in the context of yoga, we observe the opposing forces of duality. Gravity that keeps us rooted and closer to the earth against our innate urge to express that makes us rise and reach up to skies. Humans are the only animals to have aligned these two opposing forces in opposite directions by becoming vertical mobile beings. So, you come to know how your spine is so much important for you, your perception, whatever you perceive and what you get into you. So do not forget to have an erect posture, whether you are sitting, walking, standing, eating, anything. And if you want to know about the kriyas that can strengthen your spine, I've talked about it in several of my videos. Do watch it after watching this video. And now winding up, if you loved the video and found it meaningful, do not forget to give it a like, share, and subscribe. Do share it with as many people as you can. And also do not forget to subscribe. And up to next, stay safe, healthy, happy, and namaskaram.